Thanks for watching these DM7 training videos. I've already given you an overview of the console hardware and a tour of the GUI. This time, I shall introduce the options and accessories to you and help you decide which items you're likely to need. Let's begin with the consoles themselves, DM7 and DM7 Compact. DM7 has two bays with 12.1-inch touchscreen and 12 faders each, while DM7 Compact has one bay. Both have the same 7-inch utility screen and main bay with 4 faders, and the ability to bolt on the DM7 control panel. So, apart from physical size, what are the differences? The larger DM7 includes 32 mic preamps on the rear, while the DM7 Compact has 16. And the larger DM7 has two pairs of AES EBU in and out, while the DM7 Compact has only one output pair. Both have the same Dante capability, with 144 channels in and out at 96 kHz. And both have one PY card slot for expansion. More about that later. There's only one difference with internal processing capability. DM7 handles 120 input channels, while DM7 Compact manages 72 input channels. Both have the same number of effects and plugins, and the same 48 mix buses, 24 DCAs, and 12 matrices. So, select your console according to size and input channel count. Both sizes of DM7 come with software licenses for both Nuendo Live 3 and VST Rack elements. Both can be run on Windows and Mac computers and connected to the console by Dante for 64 channels using Dante Virtual Soundcard, or by USB for 18 channels. Nuendo Live is a simple and speedy multi-track recording and playback app. Using the console extension download, the channel names and colors can be copied from the DM7 series into the project, and scene recalls can trigger markers as you record. VST Rack Elements is handy software for running plugins in real time. Any VST3 plugin is compatible, and it comes with a range of Steinberg plugins. So, if you somehow reach the maximum capacity of processing within the console, you can employ more in the attached computer. Next, let's consider the DM7 control panel, which can be fitted to either side of either mixer size. In just about all situations, it will enhance the workflow and speed of operation with its extra faders, user-defined keys, knobs, surround panner, scene memory controls, and transport jog wheel. If you don't want it attached to the console, you can mount it elsewhere in a control room or broadcast truck. It has its own power supply with redundancy and only requires an IP network connection to the mixer. With the DM7 control panel comes two software upgrade kits, the theater package and the broadcast package. If you don't have space for the control panel, these packs are still available separately. Even if you're not working in a theater or a broadcast station, some of the included features could be useful. So, let's take a look. The theater pack includes a range of features which so far we have only had in Rivage PM mixing systems. The actor library, which stores several EQs and dynamics to use for specific actors at different times throughout a show. For example, if they sometimes wear a hat, or have to change between different voice characters. Each entry in the Actor library can be recalled to any channel and easily replaced temporarily if an understudy needs to take over for a few nights. Immersive mixing is also part of the theatre pack, where the mixer handles the 3D panning and other controls for Yamaha's active field control, AFC, image. Up to 128 objects can be positioned and moved around in real time. Though do remember that the AFC processing engine is a separate device controlled from the mixer. The DM7 broadcast pack, included with the DM7 control panel and available separately, includes more useful features, not necessarily just for broadcast applications. It will include 5.1 surround panning using the joystick on the control panel or the touchscreen, and the bus setup can be modified to allow the mixing of two separate 5.1 stems for dual language operation. Then 5.1 surround monitoring is also supported with speaker mute and solo buttons and various downmixing options. And output level metering will include loudness options using the LUFS scale. This is most useful for monitoring the average loudness of a show or event to make sure you are not exceeding the permitted maximum for the broadcast platform. Handy for live streaming as well. Mix minus and audio follow video features will also be included, though do note that some of these theatre and broadcast pack features may not be delivered until after a firmware upgrade. Before we finish this episode, let's consider the different audio I/O options available. First, the PY cards, a new format for DM7 series, capable of 64 channels in and out at 96 kHz. PY-64MD has exactly that capability, dual MIDI in and out connectors with several operating modes, including redundant and split options, and a sample rate converter. PY-8AE is another choice, though with only 8 channels of AES EBU in and out using a D-sub connector. This also includes sample rate converters for each pair of inputs. And PY-MIDI-GPI is the third choice for now, though this is for extra control rather than audio. It has classic 5-pin MIDI connections and a 15-pin D-sub for additional GPI connections. These could be used to control all sorts of functions, from fader start to monitor source select, talkback, tap tempo, mute group, or a scene recall. The Dante connection is, of course, where most of the external audio devices will be connected. Choose any size of RIO unit, including the most recent RIO3224D2 and RIO1608D2 with their recallable head amps and gain compensation system. These are the best match from a natural sound point of view with the internal preamps of DM7 series. Up to 24 units can be mounted and controlled from each mixer, and up to 4 mixers can control each RIO unit. I'll make another video soon about the Dante settings and how to get started with a basic system. If you haven't used Dante before, you'll be impressed with its capabilities and how it will save you time, energy, and space compared to all legacy solutions. But for now, that's the DM7 series lineup briefly explained. I'm sure you now have a good idea of which system will suit your needs best. See you again soon.